Hair is this wild, dynamic, moving, constantly changing subject in photography. It's fine, it's thick, it's coarse, it's smooth, and it's out of focus. It's all of these things. But when it comes down to it, what it is to me is a collection of pixels. There are two objectives that a retoucher is going to have when faced with hair. It's either to clean it up really nice or to extract it. So I just make the decisions about what do I like, what don't I like, what do I want to keep, and what do I want to create. Because at the high-end level, there's no faking it. There's definitely no magic button. You've just got to get your hands dirty and go for it. In 10 years of high-end commercial retouching, I've had some of the most demanding clients in the world. And that's the context in which I was able to create these techniques and workflows. Nobody does this in their free time for fun. I really wanted to make a comprehensive tutorial that deals with challenging hair extraction and cleanup problems that I just wasn't finding any solutions to shown in teaching videos or anything like that out there. The roadmap I'm giving you is going to greatly mitigate that risk of you burning 4 hours on a hair mask because you're just starting from the wrong place. You're defined in this industry by what you can pull off and what you can say yes to and what you can execute at a super high level. Being able to create ultra clean and natural masks for hair is going to put you above your competitors because not everybody can do this. If you can mask hair, you can mask anything.